in this very quick tutorial, I'm going to walk you through step by step how to create a flipbook in Canva. So flipbooks are very exciting. It helps you to actually show a visual representation of how that book will actually look like in real life. So I'm going to be taking you straight away into Canva right now. Let's do something very fast. So we are straight up inside of Canva now, and I'm going to be showing you just how to create that flipbook. But this ebook that is here is an ebook that we created in our last video, where I was showing you how to actually create coloring books for kids, and it was very exciting. You can check out the video here. And I've also created so many videos on this channel how to create ebooks on Canva, and generally how to create ebooks like this video here. It is so in-depth. I'm going to tag it up here and link in the description so that you can go ahead and watch these videos to learn how to do it. But if you have an ebook like this already in Canva, you are good to go. But if you don't already have that ebook already in Canva, and you are going to go ahead and convert it into PDF. So once you have converted that document or that any kind of thing that you want to turn into a flipbook into a PDF, you can click on this upload button here, and right inside of your downloads folder or wherever the folder is, you go ahead and upload. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on open, and it is going to upload this image here. But in my own case, I already have it here. In your own case, you're going to wait for it to upload and you go ahead and start using it. So once you already have it inside like this, this is a very nice looking ebook that I created here and showed the video. The next thing that you need to do is go ahead and click on the share button. So once you click on the share button, you scroll down and you click on more, and this more tab here is going to take us to many other features, many other tools that Canva actually has. So what I'm going to be doing here is I'm going to search for flipbook, and once I search on flipbook, these are three different tools that can help you to create a flipbook in Canva. And what I'm popularly always using is Heyzine. I love using Heyzine because it was one of the first that was added to Canva. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on Heyzine now. It's going to actually tell me if I want to use all the pages here, and the limitation with Heyzine is that it actually is able to create with just 10 pages. So I think that that's the limitation that we have with Heyzine here. But other tools, like, they are able to create more than those 10 pages, and I think that's why Canva actually added them here. But since we're just doing this for demonstration purposes, we're going to use Heyzine. You can go ahead and use the other ones if you have more than 10 pages in your design. So after selecting that I'm going to use 10 pages, or maybe if I just wanted to do for the first 3 pages, it's going to vary in your own case. I'm just going to go ahead and click on done, and this button has to show a save here. Once we click on save, it's going to go ahead and redirect us to Heyzine. So it's transferring our design to the Heyzine website, but it's not going to go and keep our design. So you don't need to care bothered about the privacy. Heyzine is very secure. So once it's preparing our design, you just need to be patient, and it's going to go ahead and redirect us to Heyzine. So if you don't have a Heyzine account, you can go ahead and just sign in with Google. It's very easy. It's going to show a link here for you to sign up with Google. But if it doesn't show you, now you can go ahead and click on view in Heyzine. So you click on this and it's going to carry you over to Heyzine for us to see our flipbook. So our flipbook is being processed, and let's see what Heyzine has for us. So you have just created a new flipbook in Heyzine, anonymous flipbooks, deleted after 1 week. So like I said, you see they don't keep the book, they delete it after 1 week. So please log in or register to save it to dashboard. So but I'm not going to go ahead to log in right now. I'm just going to show you. So this is how the flipbook actually looks like. If I click down here, you just need to scroll down, you see this little arrow here. If I click on it, you see that our book actually opens like a realistic book, and you are seeing that effect of what we call a flipbook. So this is exactly what it looks like. So you can add many other pages using the other tools, and definitely if you pay for the premium version of Heyzine, you can get to add more pages. So there are a lot of changes that you can do here. You can add a title to your flipbook and save it, and also you can also add a page effect in such a way that the way that the pages flip is like a book, an album, or a notebook. So let me just kind of take something like an album. Let's see what it looks like. So I'm going to go ahead and close, and if I flip it, you see it opens now like an album. And it is not that kind of soft like maybe a magazine. So you see that the way it opens, and definitely most of the time flipbooks are something like this. And also another change that you can do here is the background. So you can go ahead and set this white background to a different color. Let me just try to change it, let you see what I'm talking about. So if I go ahead and put it to this gradient, so it's going to change our background to that gradient color, and I think that actually helps to make the book stand out here. So for now, open our flipbook, and this is how it looks like. And also you can share, you can save this book when you sign in. If I actually go ahead now and save this book now to Heyzine, it's going to save into my account. So once I'm done with this book, I can now go ahead and share the book. So you can also add links to your flipbook. You can add links, you can add images, and add videos into your flipbook. So Heyzine has a lot of features that if you go ahead and explore these features, you're going to do so many things. So I'm going to go ahead now and share this flipbook. So if I share this flipbook here, this is a link, and anyone who actually gets this link, you open it wherever you are, you're going to be able to see this flipbook. So let me click on this button now and open our flipbook in a new tab. So we're going to be seeing a flipbook here like any other person is going to see this flipbook when they open it from that link. So that's how to actually create a flipbook very easy using Canva. And I believe that you have actually enjoyed this tutorial, and please give this video a thumbs up and smash that subscribe button for more tutorials like this, which is going to be so exciting. So see you in my next video. My name is Cyril, and do well to check this video that I'm teaching you about prompt engineering, or you can also check this other video that is going to show you how to create ebooks in Canva. So see you in my next video. Ciao.